Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Michael Metz, and let's talk about what's in the bag, or specifically, what's in the mute bag. I use a ProTek modular mute bag. I'll put the link down below. A colleague showed me about this one a number of years ago, and I was sold on it immediately. It's a great bag. Yeah, it's big. I get it. It's got lots of great things. Got a good handle. Has a nice little mesh bag on the side. Has a modular clip in the back so you can clip it onto things. It has a front type of pocket right here. Holds lots of things. Let's see, so what do I have in this particular pocket? I have my pencil. I have a mute holder. These are awesome. I like this a lot. Attaches to a stand easily. Holds all my mutes. Even has a little cup holder that can fit in it. And oddly enough, and some of you are gonna laugh, besides having a spit rag in that front pocket, I have a drum key. I don't know why I have a drum key, but I have a drum key. Maybe one day it'll get used. I always thought that maybe if a drummer needed a drum key, I could always say, hey, I have one. So the best part about this particular mute bag is that it's got six pockets. And in those pockets, you can fit more than one mute. So what do I have in my mute bag? I have a mask. You guys are gonna laugh. I have a shaker. I have used this numerous gigs, not recently. I used to have a lot more percussion, but I stopped carrying it. This one's easy, quick. I've been known to use it every once in a while, so that's kind of cool. So going through my mute bag, I will tell you that I have quite a few solo mutes, S-O-U. I'm trying to get this so that there's less of a glare on it. There we go. Solo mute, S-O-U-L-O mute. Very, very good. And I carry quite a few of these in my mute bag. I have the Solo Harman mute. I have the Solo Cut mute. I have the Solo Bucket Mute, and I also have the Solo Straight Mute, Copper Bottom. That's my Solo Mute collection, and those are the four basics. I do like them. I have used them quite a few times and enjoy the sound of them. I carry other mutes, and those mutes are as follows. And this is the one that I keep in my trumpet case when I'm not bringing my mute. I have my Dennis Wick adjustable cup mute. As you can see, it comes off. I do like my Dennis Wick cup mute. I don't think it is the same level as the Solo cup mute, but I love the sound. I don't carry my Solo cup mute everywhere. This is also another one that I carry in my trumpet case when I go to rehearsals for Albuquerque Concert Band. This is my Jor-El Copper Bottom straight mute. Most people have the Dennis Wick and the Jor-El, and so that's why I usually bring those. I have a couple of Oddity Mutes in my bag. This is the Stone Line Clear Tone Mute. It's got a very unique sound to it. I have my Wah-Wah Mute. I've had this one since high school. Long time. This is a stone lined mute. I'm not sure if they even sell these anymore. Most people just use a plunger. It's no big deal. I have velvet bag. This is my Trump Core. And this is my Lyric Mute. I do like the Lyric Mute. It has a really nice sound to it. And then last but not least, a mute that I thought I had gotten rid of many, many, many moons ago. It's got a few dents in it, but this is my Bobby Shu Soloist Harmon Mute. Bobby came out with these early 2000s. They're very unique. There is no place for a stem, unlike the solo Harmon, which you can pull the stem out and you've got, you know, that. Bobby designed these because he plays a lot of work with the Harmon Mute. And I don't think you can find these anywhere. Not that I'm aware of. It's got a few dents. I need to take it in. But it has a really, really nice sound. And I'm very happy that I found it. I really thought I got rid of it. I swear I got rid of it. And I found it buried in my flugelhorn case all the way at the bottom. Now that all my mutes are out, you can see, at least I think you can see, there is quite a nice subdivision of pockets inside this Protec mute bag. And I can carry, right now I carry on a regular basis in that mute bag, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mutes, plus a shaker and a mask, not including what's in the front pocket. So it's worth investing in. There are other mute bags on the market. I've seen quite a few. I used to carry all my mutes in a small little duffel bag and put them in a like a Crown Royal bag. Everybody does it different. This is just what seems to work for me. I do have a couple other mutes that I don't play very often anymore. I do have a Jor-El copper Harmon mute stem. I don't play this one very often. I found it to be very stuffy sounding toward the bottom. I will play it though when the situation calls for it. If I'm playing in a band and that's what everybody has, in a jazz band and that's what everybody has, I'll go ahead and pull that out and not play the solo mute. I have an old stone lined bucket mute, the 5-inch version. Nice, plays well. I've had it for years and years and years. I replaced it with the bucket mute from Solo because I like the sound of that bucket mute better and it was more adjustable. I have a couple of other mutes that I don't pull out very often because they're not for my trumpet, oddly enough. I actually have, and these are the bags that I used to use to carry my mutes. I actually have a flugelhorn cut mute. This is the Stoneline Humesenberg cut mute, and that fits my flugelhorn really well. And then I also have a Harmon mute, Jor-El copper bottom Harmon mute for my flugel. Stem comes out. That's got a very, very unique sound to it. All right, so that answers the question, what's in my mute bag? thanks for tuning in. I'd appreciate it if you would like and subscribe and share. And I will see you next time. Bye.